Hello, Les from Thailand here, and today's video is going to be about something that I know an awful lot about, and the two things are fire and also electricity. I was a firefighter in England for 30 years, so I've been to many fires, and also I had my own electrical business in England, so I know a fair bit about electricity and the dangers of it also. Now today's video is going to be about the electrical safety in Thailand. So I'm going to discuss a few things about the electrical safety in Thailand, and first of all we're going to show you this, and we're going to talk about this a little bit later on, but I'm going to show you a video first, and it's quite a distressing video. People say I'd be able to smell smoke, I'd be able to get out no problems whatsoever, but this little video I'm going to show you is very distressing, and people having to jump to save their lives. Now this was in daylight, so people should have been awake, but yet this fire originated from maybe the apartment below and it just spread. So it just goes to show that fire everywhere can cause danger to anybody, and it might not be in your property but might be in somebody else's property. But the fact that it happens and the dangers of it, and what I'm trying to say to everybody is get a smoke detector. If you get the smoke detector, it saves any of this whatsoever, and you can make your escape very early. So first of all, watch the little video. It's a scary video. I don't make any apologies for the seriousness of the video, because this happens. I went to many fires during my 30 years in the fire service in England, so I've seen it all. And I've seen some tragedy, and I've seen some awful things within the 30 years. And a lot of the problems can be caused by electrical short circuits and electrical faults. And this is what we're going to discuss after the video. So please watch the video. See you after the video. The video is very upsetting, yes, and it's distressing, but luckily it looks like the people survived from this one incident. There are many incidents that I could have put onto YouTube with regard to the seriousness of fires, how they develop. I spent 30 years in the fire brigade, so I've seen a lot of them, and a lot of people died because they didn't have a simple smoke detector, just like this. Less than £10, it gives early detection of fires. So please go and buy a fire smoke detector. They're cheap as anything. You can get them off Lazada for about 150 baht, 200 baht, and you can get them from Thai Whatsado or any DIY store. So Thai Electrics, like you've seen in the first one, this is a socket. It was in a friend of mine's house. Because I'm an electrician, I help one or two people out where I live with regards to electrics, and give them advice and help them to improve the electrics if need be. Every socket there is burnt out, so he's had something plugged into there every time, and he's just moved it along to various sockets because he keeps on working. You'll also see the photograph of the plug that was attached to the dryer. Now again, here's another extension. It's a cheap Chinese extension. I'll show you the photographs of that one and the dangers of that one. It's because the cables that go into the end of this socket, you can twist them around like that. So therefore, if you twist them around, eventually you could twist that right the way around and they're just going to pull out. And in this particular socket, that's what happened. It actually caught fire whilst I was at my friend's property, and he plugged it in and the two cables stuck together. And the most awful thing about it is that it never blew the fuse. It never blew the fuse, so if he grabbed hold of that, then it would have electrocuted him because the fuse didn't blow. Well, I'll come on to about this. You'll see some other photographs with regard to, as you look at this and you think it's got a live, a neutral and an earth. It's even marked with the earth there and the live and the neutral. Well, that doesn't mean nothing because there isn't any earths in this one. It's a cheap Chinese extension cord that you can get from Cheap Charlie's and above. Stay away from them, they're dangerous. And there's another socket that you plug into, like a multi-extension socket, so you can put three or four items in there. Again, I'll show you the photographs because the photographs are more clear than that. And another one, I'll put the photograph above so you can see, they're all burnt out. The reason why the socket's burnt out in Thailand is because the connections and the fittings are very, very loose. So that causes arcing and it burns the socket out. So what can you do to avoid these? Again, I'll put some photographs up here, the electricity board. That's where the electricity comes to in the first place. It comes to the fuse board. And I've seen some properties even without a fuse board, just one main fuse that just connects everything in the house. I'm going to go through some other dangerous things that I've seen and I've altered here in Thailand whilst I've been here. So let's start off with the fuse board. And the first picture there, you can see a normal fuse board. Now this is the basic of basic fuse boards. It has a main isolating switch which switches all the electricity off to all the fuses. But that's not a safety cutout, that's just an isolation switch. And then all the fuses that you get, your 16, your 20s, your 32 and your 10 amps. Now they're all for different size ratings, obviously. And then the next fuse board up from that, where you can fit a RCD, residual current device. Now that flicks off if there's any problem with the electricity anywhere in the house, and it just flicks off and it cuts everything off. So that can be a little bit frustrating, because if you have a problem with a light fitting or an iron or a heating tongue, something like that, it flicks all the electricity off. And then you have to go through each circuit to identify what circuit is causing the problems. And sort of the gold plated is the RCBOs, residual current breaker. They're separate breakers, and that covers each individual circuit. Now that's like the gold standard of protection over here in Thailand and in the UK, and that's what I would advise anybody to do. But as a minimum, I would say you've got to have a RCD fitted as a main circuit breaker or a main fuse, and that actually switches all the power off in your house if there's a problem. But again, with earthing, there's a lot of people don't have earths in this country, and therefore that can cause problems in itself. So it relies on a good earth for the RCD to work properly. So I'm going to explain and put a picture up about what happened, or what does happen over here, and I've seen it three or four times, and it's actually very, very shocking as to what they do, and very, very dangerous also. Somebody had an old-fashioned fuse board and they wanted to upgrade it to a device where it had a RCD on the main breaker, so actually if there was any faults it would cut off. And whilst I was changing the fuse board, I said to the lady I was going to disconnect all of the fuse board, and so I disconnected everything, and she said, well, why is my air conditioning on? Why is my air conditioning on, Les? And you've switched everything off. Why is that still working? I didn't believe her. Couldn't believe that it was working, because I'd switched everything off by the main isolator. And sure enough, the air conditioning was still working. So if you look carefully at the drawing, I apologise for the drawing, it's just a simple drawing that I did on my computer. So as you can see, from the meter, the cables go to the fuse board, and then from the fuse board goes to the light and the air conditioning units and the sockets, and that's how it's supposed to go. But the people who installed this air conditioning unit, it was too far to run the cables to the fuse board. So they decided to tap into the wires that actually go to the fuse board. So unbelievably, that means that air conditioning unit wasn't fused. There was no fuse. So that would just go on and on and on until the main line circuit breaker breaks. And that's a very, very lot of electricity going to come through there before any faults. That would certainly, 100%, if there was a fault situation, cause a fire within that property. And to actually tap into the lines was just so dangerous, it was unbelievable. And another story that I can tell you, that I actually dealt with this myself as well, because a friend of mine had a shop house, and the electrics that somebody put in was just, excuse the pun, but shockingly bad. So what they'd done, the cables that were running from the meter to the fuse board, they tapped into them cables running from the meter before it gets to the fuse board, and ran two floors of sockets and air conditioning units and lights. So there was no fusing whatsoever. And again, the only fuse that would happen to turn off is the main fuse on the main supply cables outside on the main street. The only way you could disconnect these cables was to actually disconnect it at the meter. And again, I ran a new set of cables in for him to the fuse board, and then rewired everything in his house, so everything was ran off the fuse board. And it was an RCD that actually tripped any time there was any problems within the house. Thai Electrics, it's so dangerous here. Be very, very careful as to what work you get done, and make sure that it's done properly. So the next picture that you're going to see is, I just wanted to extend a socket. I wanted some sockets in my greenhouse so I could activate the pumps for the system in the greenhouse. So the nearest socket, I actually connected to the nearest socket, but lo and behold, as soon as I opened the socket up, three red cables. So now one's supposed to be live, one's supposed to be neutral, and one's supposed to be earthed. As you can see, three red cables. So obviously I did my tests and found out which was which, and then I just wired it off from there. But again, those people who don't really know what they're doing as far as electricity is concerned, which one is earth, which one's neutral, and which one's live. It's so dangerous. There's some other photographs here I'm going to put up for the decay of light fittings. And a friend of mine asked me to put some garden light fittings in for him, but as you can see, the small cable, they don't do waterproof joints here. So invariably the Thai people just twist them together and put some tape over it, and that's their waterproof connection. I don't do that. I took the old cable out, even though it was only maybe 4 or 5 inches long, and put them a new cable, so it goes straight from the light fitting straight to the junction box that I've connected the light fittings into. But again, you can't even trust the light fittings to be made up properly. Here's another photograph, and if you look very, very carefully, you've got the blue in the live and the brown in the neutral. Totally wrong way around. Does that really matter in Thailand? Yes, it does. Because if you put it the wrong way around and it's a screw fit in, it means the outer ring is live. So potentially when you put your hand on that bulb to screw it, and if you touch the metal fitting and you haven't switched the electricity off, you could get an electric shock. Whereas if it's wired up correctly, the center pin where the bulb screws into, that's the only live part. So as you're unscrewing the bulb, you're taking it away from the live connections. Very, very dangerous if it's wired up in the wrong position, which obviously this one was, and that's from the factory sent it out like that, but it was wrong. So as you can see, there are many, many dangers within the electricity in Thailand. So take care, be very, very careful. Very careful at doing your own electric. Be very careful as to who you get to do your electrics. Make sure that they know what they're talking about. Here's another couple of examples. That this cable was by a tradesman working at a friend of mine's house. Now he ran his grinder off this. Look at the state of that socket. If you pick that socket up and that cable's loose, then you're going to get an electric shock. It's taped together, wired together. And here's another photograph of an extension cable. Just people were running a normal fan off there. The cables could easily come out of the holders, and you could get an electric shock once that's plugged in. So people treat electricity over here in Thailand with scant regard. So no wonder there's that many electrocutions and electrical accidents here in Thailand. So I hope you got some benefit from this video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. If you don't like it, give it a thumbs down. Leave your comments down below and hopefully subscribe. That would be nice. That'll help my channel along. Please don't be scared that fires are going to happen. They are still quite rare, but as you can see through looking at photographs like this, they do happen, and it is dangerous, and it can happen to anybody. So take care, be safe. From Les, living the dream in Thailand, until the next video, bye for now.